Now he says in verse 14 here, and we come now to the admonition that he gives to believers. What is that? Wherefore, beloved, seeing that we look for such things, be diligent that ye may be found of him in peace, without spot and blameless. In other words, we're to live a holy life down here. That means a life separated unto God. And friends, after all, what is really worthwhile in this earth today? What are your goals? Are you a productive Christian today, moving to a worthwhile goal? Well, somebody says, I want to raise my family. That's worthwhile. Somebody says, I want to make a good living for my family and educate my children. That's worthwhile. These things are worthwhile. But really, what is the object of your life? Is it to live for God? And if you live for God today, all of these secondary issues, I believe, will take care of themselves. And he says, an account that the long suffering of our Lord is salvation. Patient waiting is mental adjustment to the present world situation. We don't need to be alarmed today. God's sin is heaven. And things are not right in the world, but he's going to make them right someday. And this is the message of the New Testament. And not only that, Paul wrote of this. Even as our beloved brother Paul, also according to the wisdom given unto him, hath written unto you, and also in all his epistles, speaking them of these things in which are some things hard to be understood, which they that are unlearned and unstable rest as they do also the other scriptures unto their own destruction. Peter says that Paul wrote scripture, but some of them didn't quite admit it. And he says that Paul wrote of truth and depth. In my book, Simon Peter did pretty well himself here. Now will you notice, ye therefore, beloved, seeing that ye know these things. There's something we're to know today, friends. Don't be a lazy Christian, not learning the Word of God. There's no little gimmick today. There's no little course you can take in a week. There is no little program that you can go through that's going to change and revolutionize your life. There's no easy way. The way to do is to know the Word of God, not a few little verses of Scripture that you throw about and kick about like a football. He says, you know these things. Before, beware lest ye also, being led away with the error of the wicked, fall from your own steadfastness. Be a steadfast Christian. But now here is the message. But grow in grace and in the knowledge of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. To him be glory both now and forever. Amen. Oh, to know him, friends. You know what we need? We mutter and sputter. We fume and we spurt. We mumble and grumble. Our feelings get hurt. We can't understand things. Our vision grows dim. When all that we need is a moment with him. And not just a moment, friends, but a whole eternity with Jesus Christ. Until next time, may God richly bless you.